Are you in or are you out?
I don't, just go in. That's a out for me. Let's start the session. Aya, aya, let's go. Hello in Korea. My name is Jens, and I'm a singer-songwriter from Norway, the land of the fjords. And today I'm going to be your one-day love counselor. I've received some stories from Korea, and I'm going to read each and every one of them and give you my honest thoughts and advice. At first, just let me begin by saying that relationships can be very hard. If you've heard my song In or Out, there's a line where I sing,
but I need to know where you're at, so what's the deal?
Love can sometimes feel like a game where nobody knows the rules. It's like one second you're in and the next second you're out.
Are you in or are you out?
Anyways, let's start the session. Aya, aya, let's go! How many hours and how many days? Okay, first question. I have a crush on my best friend. We've been friends for a long time now, but he doesn't know that I have feelings for him. I want to express my feelings before it's too late, but at the same time, I'm afraid this will end our friendship. What should I do? That's a hard one. But I feel like you should go in. Because if you don't confess your feelings for him, you might regret it later. And even though you confess your feelings for him and he doesn't return the feelings, you can still be friends. But at least you know that you've tried. So I'm going in. Let's go. Second question. I recently met this guy and we have feelings for each other. But then I realized he lives abroad. I've heard that long distance relationships are hard, and I don't know if I like the idea of going abroad, to be honest. Should I still follow my heart? Long distance relationships can be awful. It's like going around every day waiting for the moment when you get to see your girlfriend or boyfriend again. And so that's difficult, but if you really love him, I feel like you should go in. I feel like that's the right thing to do. Follow your heart. If you really love him and you feel like you can be without him for a while, just go in. Okay, next question. Me and my boyfriend have been dating for a while now, and we're thinking of getting married in the future. Cool. But my parents disapprove of him. Oh, cool. I've tried to persuade them, but they have hardened hearts. Should I listen to my parents? To be honest, my honest opinion, I feel like you should follow your heart, even if your parents doesn't approve of it. I know it can be, that's really hard, but if you see something in this guy that you feel like he's the one for you, it's up to you. It's sort of like, I don't feel like your parents should dictate who you get to be with and spend your life with. So if you end up getting married, congratulations. You should go in on this one. Okay, let's go. Next question. Me and my boyfriend have been dating for 7 years now, and we're comfortable around each other. But I'm not sure if he's the right guy. I'm not sure if I can see a future with him. Should I continue to meet this guy? I think that's an out for me. Even though you've been together for 7 years, that should not be... I feel like that should not be the reason why you continue to see this guy. If you don't love him, you probably don't want to spend your life with him. It's sort of like, there's a lot of guys out there that will probably go well for you. So if he's not the one for you, that's totally fair. You should follow your heart. Follow your feelings. I'm out. Okay. Me and my girlfriend love each other, but we're totally the opposite of each other. I like to be outdoor and she likes to be indoor. I like spicy food and she doesn't. I like to watch movies, and she likes to read. We have little interest in common, so sometimes it's hard to match one another. Do you think this is a healthy relationship I should keep? That's a tough one, because even though you have different interests, you can still like be perfect together. But my honest opinion, I feel like I thrive most around the people that I have the most in common with. So I think I would have wanted a girlfriend that I have things in common with. So if you feel like it's a problem, maybe this is something you should think about. But if this was me, I think maybe I would have been out. It's really hard giving relationships advice. I'm really terrible at relationships myself, so this is I'm sorry. Don't listen to me. You can listen a bit to me. That's okay. But final question. Final question. Okay. This is a good one. I can feel it. I like this person a lot, and I give her all my time and love, but she never gives me a clear answer. Whenever I say, I need to know where you're at, she just smiles and gives me a wink. Do you think she's in or out? I feel like she might be in. My dude, she's clearly flirting with you. But I can see that it's frustrating that she doesn't want to give you a clear answer. I want clear answers as well. You should ask her a couple more times, like, are you really into me? And if she just keeps winking at you, that might not be, like, don't waste your time. There's plenty of girls out there for you. I think she might be in or she might be out. I think she's in. I'm a positive guy. I think she's in. I'm rooting for you. I'm rooting for you both. Well, putting that away. Okay, this was a lot of fun. I hope I can get to do this again sometime. But like I said, don't listen to my advice. I'm terrible at relationships myself. So maybe just take some pieces of the things that I say and make up your own opinion. Okay, that was it for me. Thank you so much for letting me be your one day love counselor. I had a lot of fun and I hope you got something out of the advices I gave. But please don't hold me accountable because I'm awful at relationships myself. So take care. I love you all. And I'm Jens. And I'm out.